Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and this PC inventory auditing software was recommended through comments by fellow readers in the excellent article titled Best Free System Information Utility Available on the Gizmos Freeware website, and there you have the link. This is my first impression review of Aida32. It's a review based on the first 5 minutes of testing this application. The software shown in this video is free for personal use. It's passed AVG's free antivirus and SpyBot search and destroy scanning in its compressed uninstalled state. It documents hardware devices and specifications of said hardware. It may provide some benchmark testing and may be able to identify components for which you do not have the drivers installed, those that appear as an unknown device with a yellow question mark in Windows Device Manager. This is the first impression review of Aida32 PE version 393. The compressed zipped archive is in this format. It weighs in at just under 3 megs. When you uncompress it, you have access to all the files you're going to be needing to use, including the executable. There's no installer per se. Excuse me. Right now I'm just running the software. Important to note, in this test kit, I did not install device drivers for the network interface card, and I did not install drivers for the video card. Okay, so let's see what Aida32 offers us. Computer summary, breakdown, CPU type, motherboard. I'm just going to breeze through this so you can see on screen what I see. Here's information on the BIOS, information on the system, motherboard, chassis, memory controller, processors. Caches. DL1, DL2, memory modules, DIM1, DIM2, and DIM3. Not a lot of information there for the DIMs. Sensor. CPU. CPU ID. Motherboard. Memory. It's a general breakdown there. SPD. I like SPD. It gives detail. Breakdowns of the specification of each RAM module. Very useful. Chipset. BIOS. Operating system. I will not go into operating system per se, as it gives information on my license, my Windows license. I'd rather not divulge that. Okay. Information on the accounts and logins on this computer. Here we go in display. As mentioned prior, the video drivers are not installed on this device. Now, both Aida32 and its successor, Lavalis Everest, both can detect and give information and specs of your GPU and video card, provided it is available within the internal database. Now, the video card that I'm using, the GPU, is a little more recent than what Aida and Lavalis Everest can display. They don't have any database entries for it, so they can't give information without drivers present. These are just codecs, I don't think I have to go into details. Information on the hard drive, the optical drive, storage controller, the IDE channels, logical drives. If you double click them, you'll explore them. Physical drives, here's a breakdown. No, it just lists the hard drive there. Here it lists the optical, the ASPI, parallel ATA device. So here's a breakdown of my hard drive. Here's some smart monitoring. Values normal, always passing. This is a breakdown of keyboard, mouse, and game controller, which isn't present, the game controller. Network. See, there is the report of my network interface card, despite not having drivers installed and not having the device available to Windows. Here's a breakdown of my Internet Explorer settings, which you could get in here. DirectX is installed. However, the as mentioned many times now, the video driver is not. See, it just reports it as primary display driver. Primary sound driver, however, is installed in order for me to record audio in this video. What do we have here? Okay. MIDI mapper. Ah, wrong button. It's hard to see when I lose my my mouse cursor. My mouse cursor is blinking quite a bit, and it sometimes disappears on me due to not having that video driver installed. So I'm kind of working with a 1 frame a second mouse cursor. Speaking of mouse, on to devices. Windows devices gives a breakdown of your device manager. Physical devices, excuse me. As you can see, it correctly detects the network interface card. However, since there's no database entry for the video controller, it can't detect that. Device resources gives the IRQs in use and the memory addresses that are in use. No printer installed, won't give any information. Software gives breakdowns on auto start, scheduled, install programs. It's interesting to note. Windows updates and an antivirus if I had one. The environment. Hopefully this doesn't have my Windows code in it. No, it doesn't. Okay. System files. MS-DOS, boot.ini. System.ini. Win.ini. System folders. Very good. MISC. Power management. Regional. Very good. And benchmarks. The only items that can be benchmarked in Aida32 is both memory